Hello friends, welcome to this session on number systems. In the previous video, we learned the decimal expansion of rational and irrational numbers. In this session, we will learn how to represent rational and irrational numbers on the number line. So let's start. Friends, can you tell the type of expansion of the decimal number 2.8? This is a terminating decimal. Let's represent this number on the number line. The number 2.8 will lie between the numbers 2 and 3. Now we will divide the portion between numbers 2 and 3 into 10 equal parts like this. Friends, why 10 equal parts? Because this will make the process of locating the number easy. Here, the first number is 2.1. The second is 2.2, and in this way, the last number 2.9. And the number 2.8 will be located here only. Let's take one more example. Represent the number 4.233 on a number line. This is a non-terminating recurring number. How will we represent this on the number line? Let's see. Friends, this number will lie between the numbers 4 and 5. This is a large range, so locating the number at the right position would be difficult. So let us divide this range into 10 equal parts. Now this number would lie between the numbers 4.2 and 4.3. Friends, are we now able to locate this number accurately on the number line? We have just reached the first place after the decimal, and here in this number 3 is getting repeated. Let's further divide this length into 10 equal parts. Now we can say that the given number will lie between the numbers 4.23 and 4.24. Friends, to get more accurate visualization of the representation, we will further divide the range 4.23 and 4.24 into 10 equal parts. So the given number lies between 4.233 and 4.234. If we notice the process, as we are moving ahead and dividing the parts, we are getting closer to the given numbers. Here we can say that, though we cannot accurately locate the given number on the number line, we can still represent its closest value. So, representing any number on the number line depends on how many numbers after the decimals are to be considered while representing them. To accurately or precisely locate the number on the number line, we had to divide or magnify the number line into many such 10 equal parts. So this process is called as successive magnification. Friends, so far we saw how to represent rational numbers on the number line. But can irrational numbers also be represented on the number line? We know that the decimal forms of irrational numbers are non-terminating or non-recurring. So, will we use the same process of successive magnification to represent them on the number line? Yes. Let's take an example. Represent this irrational number 4.8100 24500 6111 on the number line. This number will lie on the number line somewhere between 4.81 and 4.82. Friends, here the numbers are non-terminating and non-repeating after the decimal. Hence, even here we will not be able to precisely spot the number, but we can still come to its closest point. Friends, we will be able to represent irrational numbers on the number line without knowing their decimal expansion. Yes, there is a way of representing these numbers on the number line. Let's look at it. Let's represent root 2 on a number line. How do we get root 2? When do we get any number in the form of roots? When any number is in the form of squares, like x square is equal to 2, then we get x as root 2. Friends, when we use words like squares, square roots, Which rule comes to your mind? Yes, Pythagoras' rule. Now, if we consider a right-angled triangle ABC, where the lengths of AB and AC are one unit, according to Pythagoras' rule, we will get the length of AC as root 2. We know that root of 1 is 1 and root of 4 is 2. That means root 2 will lie somewhere between 1 and 2 on the number line. Hence, if we have to represent root 2 on the number line, then we will have to construct triangle ABC in such a manner that point A will lie on 0 and point B will lie on number 1 on the number line. We will draw a perpendicular from point B of 1 unit length. So we get the length of AC as root 2. Measure the length of AC using a compass and draw an arc on the number line which cuts the number line at point E. Point E in the number line will represent the number root 2. Friends, that is it for today. In this session, we learnt about representing rational and irrational numbers on the number line. See you in our next session where we will solve some more questions and discuss this further. Thank you.